Hello, good afternoon. My name is Laura Britt. I'm a student of the PhD program at University of Salamanca. The purpose of my thesis is to design and develop a new protocol in order to evaluate medical apps. In fact, the scope of this presentation is to show the main results that we obtained performing the first session with some medical students and professionals in order to evaluate a specific medical app. In fact, the app is called Brain System 3D that we are going to explain in other slides. Well, first I would like to explain how I came up with this research. There is an increasing number of mobile lines in the world. According to International Telecommunication Union, there are more than 6,800 million of mobile lines. And then there are 67% of students that claim that they are using more and more mobile devices and at university or learning. And besides, there are as well more physicians that are using mobile devices at work. In fact, according to ComScore study, they say that there are 60% of them that use smartphones at work, or 44% of them use them tablets. Finally, this growth has made that new business appear, as is the development of mobile apps. In fact, there are more than 1 million of mobile apps in its main marketplace, Google Play or Apple Store. So with this, we decide that it could be a good start to make a quality protocol in order to evaluate all these apps. Sorry. I don't know, or I can keep here. Okay, thank you. Well, regarding the process that we follow to establish the session, we start with different steps. First, we had to prepare all the session, establish the fix the date, prepare the classroom, and then collect all the iPads and install the app on it, because each participant had to use the app within the iPad. Then, regarding the session itself, we start with a brief introduction of the purpose of the thesis, the purpose of the session, and then we explain that we are going to distribute some documentation. After that, they have to sign an informed consent, but although all the data were anonymously, but we took some pictures, and besides, we recorded some parts of the session, so we needed the consent. So it was necessary that they sign this consent. After that, we distributed all the documentation. The documentation were was the filling context, where they explain how they use the mobile device, then a task list that they have to perform with the app, and then an evaluation itself, where they have to answer some questions in order to validate the app. When they finish, we have to collect all the information and then make the final valuation. I think it doesn't work. I think, what is this? Free session? Thank you. No. The other one there. Thank you. As for the percentage of participants, we have the number of participants were 10. were distributed equally between students and professionals, and most part of them owned a mobile device, as we can see. And then most part of them as well were fall within the range from 2018 to 25 years old. Then the app that we used to valorate during the session was called the Brain System FIDI. This app is an app that gives you the opportunity to see the different structures of the human brain, and besides gives you the opportunity to rotate and to see the different structures of the part of the brain. Besides, it gives you the opportunity to fix the image and select some parts of it. And this is the app that we use to valorate during the session. Then the protocol that we designed was based on five dimensions. These dimensions were selected based on the first part of the study that we made with this research, and we presented on the previous edition of the team conference and the team 14, where we obtained that with a survey with 124 participants, the most important characteristics that they consider when they have to download an app. So with that, we came out with these five dimensions that we used to design the protocol that after that we used in the different session. These dimensions were the content, the navigation, the reliability, the design and user interface of the app, and the security and privacy. Then the documentation that we gave to the session was basically to the task leaks and evaluation tests. These were the most important one because we based our results on this documentation. Apart from that, we gave the consent information and the context questionnaire that was based in order to collect how the documents were that we obtained all the data to analyze the results. One is the task list, that this is a list of activities that all the participants had to perform with the app. Then they have to say that if they pass or not pass the activity. One of the activities could be, for example, search some information on the app or fix some image or rotate it or something like that. And then the evaluation test that was based on 45 items grouped by the five dimensions that I explained before with the protocol. And this test was based on the five-point Likert scale. So they have to decide if they are strongly agree or strongly disagree. Then the results were divided in three blocks. One is the results depending on the task, if they pass or not pass the task. Then the score dimension that we are going to see after that. And then the total score. Regarding the task, we see what is the percentage of participants that that perform well the different activities, and what is the relationship of the perform well or not the task with the profile of the participants. So we obtained that most part of the students perform well the apps more than professionals, and analyzing the profile with the task, we see that we use the chi-squared method in order to evaluate the correlation between two variables, and we obtain that there is enough evidence to reject the null hypothesis to consider that both variables were independent, but only for the task tree. So there is a relationship with the profile with the task tree with the participants. The task tree consists of fix the image on the screen. Another result was the score dimension. In this case, we analyzed these results were based on the questionnaire that we distribute to evaluate the app, and we see that the user interface and navigation were the dimensions that were best valorated by the participants. In fact, the students gave better results than professionals. Regarding the relationship with the score dimension, we see that the profile is related with most part of the dimension, the score of the dimension, except for reliability. So it depends on the profile, if they are a student or professional, in order to give more or not a score to the different dimensions. However, the type of mobile devices is not, or the ownership of mobile devices is not a factor that could influence on the final valuation. Then we calculate as well the total score of the app, and we see in the box plot that the median for the total score for each profile, and we see that the students, the total score of a student is higher than professional, so they gave better scores than professional as well. And regarding the relationship with the profile and the mobile devices, in this case, we obtain the similar results. The profile is a factor that could influence on the final valuation, whereas the ownership of mobile devices is not a factor that could influence on it. Then, once we saw the factor that could influence on the final valuation, we analyzed the valuation itself. In this case, we consider a positive valuation if the participants gave 4 or more than 4 points to the app. For the students, we see that they gave higher scores as well, and on average, the valuation of the app was 50%. So we established a criteria in, that for 70% in order to obtain the certificate level. So in this case, the app that we valorate, it does not reach this minimum. So we couldn't give them the certificate level. Yes. This is some pictures that we took during these different sessions, and I must say that all the students and professionals were very positive as well, and very proactive to collaborate in this session, so we obtained very a positive experience with it. And finally, the conclusion, we suggest that the profile, it could be a factor that could influence on the final valuation of the app, whereas the ownership or the experience with mobile devices is not a factor that could influence on it. However, this only is the first step of the research, and we must obtain more samples in order to make again the valuation and collect more data and have the analysis as well. So, that's all, and thank you very much for coming.